So we're going to define chaos. Chaos is aperiodic, long-term behavior in a deterministic system that exhibits sensitive dependence on initial conditions. So this is a working definition, and there's some jargon words in there. Aperiodic means just not periodic. So a fixed point or a limit cycle, some periodic motion would be periodic. Quasi-periodic would also count as aperiodic, but quasi-periodic would not exhibit sensitive dependence on initial conditions. So if you have motion on a torus, two initial conditions will track each other and just lag somewhat. So they won't. There won't be this exponential growth away from each other. It's a deterministic system, meaning it's not driven by noise or stochasticity. And some people might leave this out, but we can put it in there. Long term, you could have transient chaos. So something would have maybe exhibit everything, but just for a short time, and then settle down to a behavior that is periodic. But by long term, we mean it never seems to settle down. So this is a working definition of chaos. And some people might have some, you know, different nuance to it. This sensitive dependence on initial conditions would be if you have a positive Lyapunov exponent for this, at least that last one. So that's necessary, but it's not sufficient. So now let's define an attractor. An attractor, and there's some disagreement about this. Let's call this attractor A. It's going to have some properties. It's an invariant set, meaning if you start in A, you stay in A under the dynamics. It also attracts an open set of initial conditions, open set in the phase space. And the third one is kind of odd, but there is no subset of A that satisfies one and two. So this is sometimes called the minimal condition. So let me give you an example to show you the need for this last thing, number three. Right, and we haven't said anything about chaos. To have an attractor that's also chaotic, it would be then something new. So here's an example that just sort of illustrates this idea of the attractor. We've seen this system before. I think we even saw it in class. I'll just draw the picture of it. So the y-axis and the x-axis. The origin is a saddle. So along the y-axis, things are coming in. Along the x-axis, things are going out, but then they're going to stable points. So these are stable, and everything is, you know, nearby going to the stable nodes. So this would be like after a pitchfork bifurcation in 2D. Now, what are some candidates for an attractor here? This does have an attractor. What are some candidates? One, it would be the origin. It is an invariant set. If you start at the origin, you stay at the origin. So let's mention candidate attractors and see if they work out. The origin. It does not attract an open set of initial conditions. It only attracts things along the y-axis. So if I start with anything that's not on the y-axis near it, those go away. So it doesn't attract. So it fails too. So doesn't work. It looks like the x-axis is pretty good, right? Everything is going to the x-axis. So in this case, y dot is equal to negative some positive number times y. So that means everything is going to the x-axis. So it satisfies one. It's an invariant set. If you start on the x-axis, you stay on the x-axis. It satisfies two because an open set of initial conditions ends up on the x-axis. But there is a subset of the x-axis that is attracting. So it actually fails three. How can we see that? If you look at the interval between these two stable points, that's also an attractor. It's just a portion of the x-axis. So because there is a subset of the x-axis that everything gets attracted to, this fails the minimal condition. Everything on the x-axis eventually goes to these fixed points. So the fixed points, the two stable points, there's no condition here that this has to be a connected set. So the two stable points, if you start on them, you stay on them. So they're invariant. They do attract an open set of initial conditions. In fact, like the right side stable point attracts everything to the right of the y-axis, and the left side stable point attracts everything to the left. There's also, because they're points, there's nothing smaller, so they also satisfy three. So that's it. For this, the attractor is the two stable fixed points. Some people add a fourth requirement. Some people add to the definition of an attractor, trajectories that start near A stay near A for all time. So that's an extra condition. And you could write this in terms of epsilon delta type thing about neighborhoods. But let me just give you an idea of it. If we have, remember that saddle node infinite period bifurcation in 2D? So there was we have a limit cycle. We do before the bifurcation. And it's a stable limit cycle. So there's an unstable point and things are kind of spiraling off, going to this stable limit cycle. But then we have a sort of half stable fixed point that shows up. So this would be, you know, theta dot is 1 minus sine theta. I think r dot was like r 1 minus r squared. What is this point? This point seems to attract, this point would qualify as an attractor for points 1, 2, and 3. It's invariant. It attracts an open set. There's no, because it's a point, there's no subset. But there are trajectories that start near that point and yet leave. They leave some neighborhood. So if we do a little neighborhood, what's happening to the people in this neighborhood? Over here, this point is in the neighborhood, but it leaves, goes outside, and it does come back, but it does leave the neighborhood. So it would fail this other criterion, but it's kind of up to you. For the Lorenz attractor, it does indeed satisfy number 4 as well. So it's usually put as, given any neighborhood U of A, then there exists a neighborhood V of A, such that if you start in V, you'll stay in U forever. This also sort of brings up the difference between attracting and Lyapunov stable. This point is attracting because all points do end up at it, right? There would be that. This is actually a saddle point, right? It's kind of, well, not really saddle point because things are coming from both sides. Things end up there. So it's an attractor according to definitions 1 through 3. And that's sort of a global idea compared to Lyapunov stable. It's definitely not Lyapunov stable because everything in this left half leaves. So Lyapunov stable, it's similar to this neighborhood idea. If you start within a neighborhood of the fixed point, even though you may leave that, there'll be some other larger neighborhood that you don't leave for any size. So it needs to be kind of infinitesimal as well. So this point would actually be an attractor or attracting set, yet not Lyapunov stable. So it could be that this number 4 is kind of related to the idea of Lyapunov stable. You could read more about that if you want. This sort of discussion of what's an attractor was just to say the Lorenz equations for R equals 28, sigma equals 10, B equals 8/3 have an attractor. And the dynamics of the attractor itself show chaos, which by this we mean it shows sensitive dependence to initial conditions. And it shows that aperiodic behavior, it shows chaos. And so that's why you combine those two terms we've defined, you get a chaotic attractor, or the name that people gave it because it was strange. It wasn't like a limit cycle or other things. Strange attractor. And we'll say more about the Lorenz attractor next time and some ways that Lorenz tried to understand it.